All right, so I'm going to give this another try. So I created a patch for ref policy, which finally, at least hopefully, finally deals with some issue that has been around for a long time. It's actually in Red Hat Enterprise Linux 6, I think. And it goes back a long time. It was introduced by Fedora, I think. And let's have a look at the patch. Let's create a patch on the clipboard. And then fpaste that so that we can have a view of that. So basically, there was this bug in the init run daemon interface. Well, bug, it was just wrongly implemented, because callers of this interface actually transition role and domain transition to init daemon domains on init daemon entry files. Now you can actually achieve the same if you just domain and role transition to the init script domain on init script entry files. So, and actually by doing that you'll deal with a lot of problems, because init daemon entry files can actually also be used as session daemon entry files. So if you label your, if you transition, if callers of this interface transition on the init daemon entry files, then you can't use that file for your, for a session daemon, or if you want to run it without a domain transition at all, because it's already, there's already a transition or a role and domain transition specified. So that's an issue, because for example you have Pulse Audio, which is a program that can be executed both by init, so it's an init daemon domain, it's an init daemon, but it can also be run in a session. Now for example, sysadmin calls this init run daemon interface conditionally if direct init rc is set, the tunable is set, then sysadmin calls this interface, and then when sysadmin runs for example Pulse Audio, Pulse Audio will start as if it was started by init. But sysadmin can also run GNOME session, can also log in a GNOME session, and then it will also need to start Pulse Audio, and different rules might apply, you might want to apply different rules to that scenario. So, and the same goes for Unconfined T, although Unconfined T was previously not actually treated the same way as sysadmin T with regards to direct init RC. And that's also part of this patch. So basically what this patch does is it treats unconfined T the same as sysadmin T with regards to direct init RC. So basically if you set direct init RC to yes when you build the policy, then both unconfined T as well as sysadmin T will role and domain transition on init scripts. And then I also changed the init run daemon so that that it doesn't, that callers of this interface do not transition to init daemon domains on init daemon entry files, but instead transition to the init script domain on init script files, so that you don't get that conflict. So that's what this patch actually basically does, and then it actually adds here a conditional. This is minor, but it's related. And so what actually to test this is pretty hard, because on the one hand this is a patch to reference policy. If you want to this patch doesn't apply as is to Fedora, because Fedora made a lot of related changes to work around this issue. Basically, Fedora hacked around this issue. For some reason, Fedora thought, okay, we can't edit this interface. This interface must be right, so we'll just work around it and add all kinds of other rules, and then just leave this in place. And then later on, they decided to remove it anyways and leave all the other rules in place. So yeah, that's just unmergeable, and it's just very hard to test. And on the other hand, I can't test it on Red Hat Enterprise Linux 6 either, because, well, that's probably easier to test, but you still have the same issues where it diverged quite a bit. And also ref policy, I couldn't actually test ref policy as is, because ref policy has the name file transitions which aren't supported on Red Hat Enterprise Linux 6, so it might not install. Not sure, don't want to try it either anyways. So I'm just going to try this on Fedora 19, or actually Fedora 20, I guess, and just see if it works. So on this system, for example, let's just ps aux grab pulse audio. See, here is still the issue is still in place here. So pulse audio is still running with the system RL, and that's basically a side effect of the init run daemon. Because init run daemon says, okay, if Uncle Fine T runs a file with pulse audio exact T, then role transition right there and then. But that's actually was the idea, was to only do that for pulse audio running as a daemon, init daemon, and not as just a session daemon, because this is basically a session daemon, I would call it. So yeah, we need to fix this, and this is what I'm going to actually try to achieve. And I tried this before, but it didn't actually work out, because there's so many modifications in Fedora that, yeah, I forgot some modifications, and so it was a mess. So I'm just going to give it another try, make the temp cd temp. So I have this simple checklist that basically can be used to create a modified package. Checklist this modifier Fedora 20 RPM. So I'm just gonna go through this checklist, I guess. And then create a package that is modified, and hopefully I get something that is actually resembling the implementation in ref policy, at least for the biggest part. But that might actually not be the case, so we'll see where it gets us. Because Fedora has just so many changes, that's unbelievable. For what? I wonder for what? Because it works pretty decent in ref policy, so I just don't know why it diverged so much, why it had to divert so much. Takes a while. I got a slow system. Well, it's a fast system, but my audit configuration is very hefty, and so this note taking application is cool, but it edit stuff. It's cool, but it's slow. All right. Now we need to edit stuff, and now we need to actually, yeah, try to be careful here. CD, well actually this nano policy modules system init if start here. Now the things that are important to us currently is the init daemon domain. That's basically what it all, that's actually one of the huge things here, so we want to make that at least a little bit resembling, or at least not a little bit, just very resembling. Now I'm not gonna get rid of any requires because that's not applicable. We're just going to remove this whole block here. But actually there's more that we need to do, so I'm going to open init if and go to the init daemon domain interface and just have a look at how that's done and have to compare that. So see this here, this type transition init rc domain, that's just, this is a Fedora modification and I don't want that, so I'm going to just do I'm just going to do this here. So remove this stuff here. Just do this here. This direct init entry can be removed. And this at least looks to a little bit the same. So that should, in theory, be okay. I guess. Now, next, we'll want to change the init run daemon interface. So this also modified, I think. Let's have a look at the init run daemon here. Arm init run daemon. And this is our version. So I'll just copy this over and just paste that in as is. There it is. This is our version. Now, I think this is about it for the interface file. So we change this here and we change this here, and this should already take care of it. Now we need to go to the type enforcement file, I think. Although, there's so many hacks. There's so many hacks there. I really need to also take care of this because this is a hack for systemd. Very ugly, very, very ugly. That's why it's so hard to test. Because, yeah, you have to deal with all kinds of issues. Now, hopefully, this will be sufficient. Not sufficient at all because it's missing init rc. See the init transition domain, blah blah blah. What a mess. And then wondering why nothing gets committed to ref policy. You can't just work around everything. You need to take some time integrating this stuff. So yeah, what was I? Oh yeah, type enforcement file. So now there. Is risky, but there are also rules that it's gonna break like hell. Pretty sure. Modifications are I know there are some modifications here somewhere. But anyways, let's just leave it because I'm not gonna find that in short notice. Alright, so let's have a look at sysadmin. And this sysadmin is in roles sysadmin. Now here, this looks let's have a look at how in it. So here you have a bunch of stuff. See, here he added this stuff in its script role transition just to work around stuff. then there's also other stuff here. Init.exec script files. I'm just going to remove that. And then there's this init run daemon here, which is fine. This is fine. This looks okay. This is from ref policy. So what he did was he just basically broke an direct init RC, because he says here unconditionally role transition and transition init run script files. So that's probably a transition to the init RC on scripts. Well, if you just said init RC no, then that should have happened. That should have happened if the init run daemon interface was right. Okay, so let's see. This is should be probably be working now. Unconfined T, which is has a similar problem, but there's some other problems there as well. Roles, unconfined user, is it? So init system domain, init role transition here. Now this rule is not strictly needed here, but I'm gonna leave, actually I'm not gonna leave it, I'm gonna edit, remove that as well, because it's just not needed. It shouldn't be needed. It's added to my init run daemon interface. And here you have init run daemon, it's here. And here you have the init dump transcript. So it's that's one big hack. And this, I'm going to remove this and instead add that to where it should be. Here it should be. And I'll just copy that over from a patch. That should make things happen, but yeah, well, shoot, and actual facts, this different, two different things. Okay, so that is that. Now there's another thingy, and that's minor. So these can be left in place, or they aren't used anyways. And then this shit here, but this is not gonna work as is in Fedora, because Fedora basically replaces the files, does it manually for some in some way, but it doesn't really matter. This is minor compared to the other stuff. So basically we got it now, so let's see what's next step. What the next step is, we need to commit. Git show, and here you have what we did. So it's actually in an exec script file, so it didn't actually domain transition script file, so it just ran it. Not sure why that is, why he did that. Whereas here it does domain transition script, so it treats sysadmin different than unconfined, and that's something I shouldn't have done. I wouldn't have done. Anyways, this okay. So this is basically the whole thingy. Next step. Create a diff. Next step is to cd and then bump spec. Now CV. And Bob's back. And then that I'm going to have to make a couple modifications here. So let's first deal with the basics. Add the patch in there and apply the patch. Nano. And then apply the patch. Which is in prep. Okay, now what we want to do is we don't want to build stuff that we don't need. So we don't want to build minimum. We just want to build targeted, because else it's going to take longer than I want it to take. Right. Now, another thing that we want to edit is we want to set direct admin or direct init RC to true. Make commands and install commands, which is 3. We want to set it to true because it's disabled by default, but the idea is that for targeted policy you should just enable it. This is deval. Minimum, we don't do minimum, we do targeted. Oh, build targeted. Specified. I would have sworn there is another. Well, I guess not. I guess this was all. This is the whole thing. Install commands, make commands. Make commands. So yeah, this is it. Okay. So that's also taken care of. So we're building in with direct sysadmin, yes. And we're only building targeted policy, and we got our modifications, and we're gonna patch set up. So let's head on to the next step. The build requires, we don't have to deal with that because I already did that. So it's set package local to build it, and then hopefully it'll actually build. That shouldn't take too long. Let's just wait first for it to build. before I'm going to actually install a virtual machine to test it. It shouldn't take too long. It doesn't install the docs. The docs is what's taking the longest. It's just kind of hard to reproduce because there's so many stuff with systemd, and it's just so modified, the init related stuff, that chances are that I'm just breaking it like hell. Whereas Debian is basically pretty much just a vanilla ref policy with maybe a couple patches, a couple differences. So test it on Debian is nice, but the problem is that I hate Debian packaging. I hate guilt. That is such a bullshit component of Deb. And the weird thing is some people actually favor Deb over RPM, but when it comes to packaging, I prefer RPM for real. So yeah, that's hard for me to test it on Debian because I've waste more time packaging than actually testing anything. So I'm just asking someone else if he wants to create a package for me with a patch. And then in the meanwhile, I can be productive. Because that's just something I will never get used to Debian packaging. I know how it works, but somehow it just always goes wrong. Something always messes up. Alright, so then when this is done, I'm going to install a new guest, which also takes a little while, unfortunately. But yeah, that's all part of the job. Shit, it's actually building the docks. Monolithic is no, but this is install docks. MLS. Oh no, no, not MLS. Okay, so it seems no, it's still not. Nope, it's going to all the manual pages. it's a nice idea, this manual stuff, but I would probably create a separate package for it. Because you might not want this, but this is part of the develop package, I guess, so. But then still, you might not want it. It should be part of the docs package. Well, isn't this part of it? Yeah, this. I'm not sure. I'm not sure. Devel looks like Devel, but okay, so it's done. It builds. That's what I wanted to know. And it's actually also processing a doc package, and I just told it not to build a doc package, so not sure why that is. Okay, so I need to actually cd git gen.ks, and then I have a gen.ks script here, gen.ks. And this basically creates a kickstart file and loads that to fpaste, and then it also creates a script that I can use to install a guest using that kickstart file. So basically kind of automated. And the kickstart file has all kinds of modifications that so that it basically set up properly the system. I need to actually do it like that. So it's uploading a file, and now it created the test install and test KS. And now it's root sudo home joe git gen KS test install, and this expects a disk path, so that's def sdj1. this should in theory do it. This basically creates a minimal Fedora system called test period network one, and it sets up some basics, adds my SSH key and stuff like that, and then we'll use that, we'll the package that we just built, we'll just copy that over to this system and test it on this system, see if it behaves. Now it might not, I might just have overlooked stuff. This is fully automated, so that's cool. Don't have to do anything. And that's basically the scripts that I created, because I actually do this a lot, creating virtual machines for testing purposes and then just destroying them. So this the gen.ks just creates the kickstart file and creates a script that actually installs the guest using that kickstart file. And that kickstart file has all kinds of modifications. with regards to mostly security. Now the shitty thing is that I don't think you can actually test in a running system whether a policy was built with some tunable or not on or not. That sucks. Because I'm not 100% sure whether I actually did it proper in the spec file to make it built with Dart sysadmin. True. Think so, but not quite sure. Post installation tasks. Rebooting. I'll need to update this system. I don't actually need to do that. Not yet, at least. We have 237. 237. Yes. SSH, DO, or SFTP. At first, oh, actually, CD, no arch, and then SFTP Joe at, actually I don't need to do that, 192.168.100.237. Yep. LLS, and then put, and we only need two packages, this one. That now SSH Joe 192.168.100.237 ls sudo shell abc123 ls rpm uvh. Just to be sure, I'll just set up 40 because might just shit might just hit the fan. RPM, UVH, shit might just hit the fan. Let's just also add it to see as a Linux config, just to be sure that it boots. Because I did some stuff with regards to systemd, so it might actually not boot anymore. Sit down, reboot now. Then see if it still comes up. It takes a while because of socket activation. Systemd is one of the regressions that systemd introduced. Socket activation should be supposedly make it faster, but now actually takes longer to oh, this is actually pretty fast. Okay, PS out. Just see out search and avcts recent sudo shell abc 123 out search and avcts recent, and it's actually clean. That's weird. So are you saying that I did it properly or not? Now let's just cd etc rcd initd and just create a test script, nano test shell in shell, and then printf. User bin ID Z, I think exit and EOF. And tick on it because it's not labeled properly. So init RC exec T test shell, and that's all Z. Now let's see test, and this works. This works. Okay, now let's just take a different approach here, or nano HTTP shell. Bin shell. Print F, same idea. Check on that. HTTPD exec T HTTPD shell, and then tmod that. HTTPD shell. Now, let's. So, HTTPD. So, let's see what happens if I run HTTPD. It doesn't domain transition. That means that that's proper behavior, because previously there would have been some issues here. because it would have probably raw transitioned on HTTPD, and it might have actually ended, yeah, it probably would have also domain transitioned on HTTPD. Now let's just add a test, nano test shell, see if that works. And that works. So this actually seems to work. And let's just yum update the system. Oh, and let's first see if we have HTTP now. DS ABC user ABC and then SELinux error and then today TS today. No ABC denials at all. So this seems to have fixed it. Appears yum update. But we're far from there yet. Because what we next want to do is we want to compare this behavior to the behavior of actually let's just not do this we want to compare this behavior to the behavior of when initRC is set to 0. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to login this not installed funk. But we haven't changed much with regards to sysadmin, so I'm not going to test sysadmin because we haven't changed that much with regards to that. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to I'm going to exit. And then CD out of here. Oh. I'm still on the test system. LS, CD out of here. And now I'm going to actually bump the spec again. And edit the spec again. Build doc. But it's set to 0, but it actually builds it. So what deal that? But anyways, the main idea is that we're now going to build a package without direct init. So we have the targeted bits, so we set that to N. If we're targeted, what to do with docs though? So it talks a build. Here it talks. But it doesn't have a if build docs. But I'm not gonna fuck with that right now. But yeah, so this if build docs macro doesn't actually do anything for some reason. So yeah. Now actually we'll just fat package local again And now it's build a package with direct sysadmin set to n. No. And then we're gonna see if that actually behaves the way I expect it to behave. Hopefully I can see. That it actually built with an N. It goes too fast, can't actually see it. But we'll see it when we install the module. It should behave differently. It shouldn't transition now. Or once we install this module, and if it does, then something is wrong. And then later on at the end, if everything goes well and everything expects the way I expect it, or everything works the way I expect it, then I might actually test this with sysadmin as well. Sysadmin as well, it's important. Direct init RC is set to nil, but that's for man, and that was before the same thing. Now it's going through all these manual pages again. Set to nil, none. But that doesn't mean anything. Yeah. go. Skill of my disk, these small HTML files. Okay, it's now building a packet. Building a doc packet, although I told it not to. It's building a sandbox as well, but that's probably alright. Go. Alright, CD no arts. So now we have two versions. And then we have the SFTP here, where are you? And we need to have version 2 also uploaded. Put version 2. And put targeted version 2. Sudo shell abc123. Now let's just see yum install. Hopefully it doesn't pull in any policy dependencies, because then the policy core details Python, I think. And it doesn't pull in any. So that's cool. Now what first I'm gonna do is I'm gonna see if I can SMS test sysadmin so that that has the same behavior. So by default I'm set to unconfined view, so as you manage login add as my name is Joe and I want to go to start view with range of S0. C0C123 and that's Jake. Now let's have a look at SMN's user list. Staff has access to unconfined as well as sysadmin. Okay, so that's what I want. So now when I log in, should be stuff. Yeah. So now sudo shell let's just say type sysadmin t role sysadmin r. I should have the same behavior with regards to the init scripts ID. Let's just go to cd etc rcd init see. And let's just run test shell. And this is the same behavior. And let's just run HTTP shell. And that's the same, that's good. This is good behavior. So this works. This works well as well. Let's do an auto search if I can. No, I see the mouse. That seems fine. The message. Grab. I denied. Just to make sure. Nothing there. So everything is still working smoothly. Now. I'll just log in as root. That's not possible. I'm not allowed to log in as root. Funk. So I'll just sudo t and confine t. Although it's permissive mode anyways. R and confine r. But it's just for shits and giggles. So now I'm going to RPM UVH. Now it's the directories admin or direct init RC of. Now the behavior should change. Now when I run test, it should not end up in the HTTP domain with the system R role. That's theory. All right. So let's cd etc rcd init v. Right. It works. Now let's do the same for sysadmin. Run test again and it should not transition, and it doesn't. Right. And it's labeled properly, isn't it? Everything is still labeled properly. We don't want to have any misconceptions here. No, it's still labeled properly. So this is the behavior. So if you have direct init RC set to nil, then you need to use run init to start init script. But if you have set to yes, then you can just basically execute init scripts without using run init or anything. And the nice thing is that if you now basically, so if I now basically install a graphical user interface, which I should do, let's just also see if you have AVC announced again, just to be sure. No, AVC announced. So let's just yum install GNOME desktop. And this is probably not the proper way to do it. So let's just yum group list. No, desktop, let's just yum group install GNOME desktop. issue all of the packages. But at least my system is, my internet connection is pretty fast, so we have like almost 10 megabits. It'll end up with 10 megabits probably. 100 megabits. 9, 9, 2, 6. Oh, it's over now. Eight. Damn, no, 9. That's unfortunate. Now the problem is that I'm mapped to stuff, so I'll go back to actually first I'll check with stuff and then I'll later on I'll check with so it's 70 megabits about round about. First I'll check with stuff in the graphical user environment and then I'll check with interfind. Just want to make sure that this actually works the way it's supposed to work. But yeah, Fedora made it all complicated and, well, it really was just as simple as just modifying the Integrum daemon interface. And that's it. And then make Unconfined T tunable for direct init RC. And then that's it. I don't see the problem there. Why it all has to be so chaotic and so inconsistent. That bothers me, to be honest. Because, well, then they look at blaming us for, oh, nothing gets upstreamed. Yeah, nothing gets upstreamed because it's a bloody mess. It's not because I don't want to upstream anything. I would love to upstream many as much as possible, but if it's a mess then I'm not going to do that, because Rift policy has to deal with other distributions as well, and we have other problems as well. Fedora basically just needs to make work in Fedora, and it's easier, I guess. Raining again. Ouch. And it's cold, but not as cold as other parts of the world. But it's cold. Not freezing. For this time of year, it's probably relatively warm. Almost done. This is on a USB disk, so that's why it's the installation of the files is slow. But at least it doesn't have the audit rules that slow down the disk I/O. Because on my host system I have audit rules that record every time you create a file or change the security attributes of a file. That's why the building of packages takes so long, because especially with these man pages, for every man page audit needs to write a record, and those rules, those audit rules are not installed on my guest machines, only when a user runs setuid application and stuff like that, but not disk I/O, not when files get created or files get changed and stuff like that. Because if those rules would be there, then this would be really, 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 really slow. So this is also basically an example of what the workflow is if you want to actually make major changes and test them. And this is basically how I would do it. And even though that ain't perfect, I know that this works now, at least so far, that this modification works, but it's not perfect because there's now all kinds of dangling interfaces that I can remove and stuff like that. So those, for example, those role transitions on init scripts, that interface, that's probably now become useless. So you should remove them, although that's not a problem because I'm not adding interfaces or not merging interfaces that aren't used anyways, although we agreed that we should, but I'm still kind of hesitant to do that because I just don't like that idea. I know that it's useful to have interfaces for audit to allow dash capital R, but audit to allow dash capital R is a piece of shit in the first place. So we're going to add all these interfaces that we that are unused just for a piece of shit functionality, but that actually don't work. That most of the time suggests interfaces that are either too permissive or aren't related at all. Yeah, that's why I'm just hesitant to add interfaces and templates and patterns and permission sets that aren't used. Now cleanup phase, and then after this I probably need to update I need to update as well, because else we have updated a graphical desktop environment on a outdated base, although that shouldn't be a problem because the dependency should be should take care of that, but sure. This takes a while. NSPR. So now let's assume a bit. See, there are a couple of things there as well, not too much. Oh, libsc Linux. There was an issue with libsc Linux. Blah 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 blah. Now nano etc is Linux config a force. And then ship then halt now. And now I'm going to go to the graphical environment. Not it, so don't get confused by this stuff. Now it probably won't start in init 5. This is in a forcing mode, by the way, if all is well. Seems all green, so that seems to boot fine. So it doesn't actually search on HTTPS recent. We have some issues here, but this is with regards to network manager init rc process signal kill signal. Okay, but that's not a big deal, I guess. This is not related to the stuff that I added. What I want to do now is I want to init 5. And then I want to just log in. This is as stuff in a forcing mode, so it might not, so stuff might not work properly. But we'll see. And this is with direct init RC to node. Okay, let's have a look at IDZ. IDZ. Oh, damn, this all sucks. Just stop. PSXC. Now let's have a look at Pulse. Pulse Audio. Now this is actually right. So Pulse Audio does the main transition, but that's because we're in a strict as a strict user, so that's fine. But it didn't roll transition, and that's exactly what we want. We don't want to roll transition, so this actually this looks good, exactly the way I expected. And so this is actually nice. So sudo roll sysadmin rt sysadmin t abc 123, and then I'll search and abcts. Let's just do user abc, and as long as error, but we're in a force mode, ts recent, and then auto to allow that straight away, and it's still fine. This actually looks, this is actually working pretty neat. We just have a couple of small issues, nothing serious. Let's do a PS out, see if everything runs properly. We have RPM, it runs fine, syslog runs fine, redef is okay, as he dispatch, that's fine, also firewall B, syslog, yeah, this is all running fine. This seems to be okay. This is fine. Although we should actually deal with this. This should probably not run in the in a domain, because this is actually run by unprivileged users, in this case DDN. But if you here you have it actually running by in Joe, so now Joe actually runs in the inner domain. You don't want that, as far as I know, so we really need to deal with this shit here. But yeah, other than that, it's just fine. So for example, ID, so again, let's just cd etc, let's just restart a service normally with the systemd, see that if that also still works. So we do have PS out, crony, don't we? Grab crony. Yeah, so let's just try crony. System control restart crony. And then just grab it again. And that's fine. This is fine. I'll search just to be sure. Yeah, this is fine. So this is my patch. And it works. As far as I tested it, and you've been looking at how I test this, it just works. Move past this. Where is it? Temp here. F20. And then where's my patch? My customizations. My modification patch. So this patch works on Fedora 19. And it cleans up a little bit with these script role transition stuff and this abuse shit, which can just be removed. Also the interfaces, this stuff, this can also be removed, this can be removed. There's a lot of bullshit in there. But remember that if you apply this patch, you want to build your targeted policy with direct init RC if yes. And now currently Fedora builds the package with direct init RC is no. So you want to do that. And then you get consistent behavior, then you get the same behavior for sysadmin as for unconfined. They both can then just start services without running. So yeah, I'll just save this patch here and I'll upload this. As far as I'm concerned, this is just fine, this just works fine. Although I would actually clean up, I will just see if anything else calls these interfaces, these role transition, and this. If not, remove them. That's this one as well. This in a DOM script is actually used by other interfaces, but by other domains. But. And then we can also should get rid of these, because ref policy will get rid of these. So if I was Fedora, I would remove any reference to this stuff here, because this is unneeded. This is unneeded. And also, yeah, I would probably implement this. This seems to just work. So why would you make it complicated if this just works? Now, maybe Fedora has a reason to create that stupid initrc domain or initrc, yeah, daemon or initrc domain attribute. But as far as I can see, it's useless. Maybe it saves you a few rules, but it looks useless to me. So yeah, hopefully this will be useful to someone.